Hey everyone, here's how to reverse time remap on Premiere Pro just like this. To begin, I just want to say I don't have any audio, so I'm going to be using this marker here as a reference point. Also, keep in mind that my main sequence is at 60 frames per second. Yours could be anything else, it could be 24 or even 30. So just keep that in mind for now, because what I'm going to do is nest my clip. So right click, nest, okay. And then you want to open up the nested clip, so double click. And then you want to change this so the time base, right now you can see it's 60 frames per second. This needs to match the frame rate of your source. So for example, if I head into the project tab, I can check the frame rate of my clip. So right click, head over to properties, and you'll see the frame rates here. So mine is 23.976, yours could be 30 or even 60, but change it to that value there. So what I'm gonna do is head over to sequence, sequence settings, and change it to 23.976 and click OK. Close out of this nested sequence. Now we're ready to time remap. So first of all, you want to expand your video layer. So you can do this by just hovering over this bar here and just manually expanding, or just hold Alt on your keyboard and use the scroll wheel. So what you want to do is right click on this FX box right here, head over to time remapping and select speed. Then you want to right click on your clip, head over to speed/duration, and change the time interpolation from frame sampling to optical flow and click OK. So what I'm going to do is place a keyframe at the start, and what I'm going to do is make it gradually slow down over time until it reaches my marker right here. So at the start, I'm going to hold Control on my keyboard and click, which is going to place a keyframe. And this keyframe here, I'm just going to drag it all the way to the right. So somewhere around here. We are going to make a lot of adjustments, so it doesn't really matter where you place it. So the first thing I'm going to do is drag this side here down. So hold Shift on your keyboard, which will lock it into multiples of 5. So what you want to do is hold Shift, click, and drag it down. So I'm going to go for, let's go for 20%. Okay, that looks fine. And then I'm going to head to the start and hold Shift once again. And I'm going to drag this part here, not this. That's the keyframe itself. And plus, you'll notice it because your cursor changes when you hover over the bar. So what you want to do is click and drag it up. So I'm going to go for, let's go for 175. If you can't do this, don't worry about it. I want it to be really fast at the start and then slow down at the end. So yeah, you can pick any percentage you like. So I'm done with that. I'm going to make a cut at my reference point and get rid of this. I'm now going to duplicate my clip, so hold Alt on your keyboard, click and drag it. So place it right next to it. Then what we want to do is right click on this clip and select nest, click OK. Then you want to right click again, head over to speed/duration and select reverse speed and click OK. So now if we play it back, you can kind of see what I'm trying to go for. You've already got two questions. First of all, it's so choppy. What's going on? Just be patient. We're not done yet. And secondly, the clip is too long. Don't worry. What you can do is right click on it, head back into speed/duration, and use this speed percentage to determine the length. So for example, if I change it to 200, you can see it's now shorter. At the moment, I'm just going to leave it at 100. So to check the result and see if it actually looks okay, what you can do is head all the way to the start, press I, and then head to the last frame of the second clip and press O, and head to the top. So sequence, sequence settings, copy my video preview settings, so QuickTime, Apple ProRes 422, click on Reset, uncheck both of these boxes, check this one down here, click OK, head back into Sequence, and render into Out. Hopefully this looks smooth. It kind of looks boring. I don't know, I'm not feeling it. So as I said, what you can do is right click on your second clip, speed, duration, and change it to something higher. So let's go for maybe 250. Which is going to shorten the duration. I'm going to render that again. Let's see how it looks. Yep, so as you can see, it's much faster than before. Oh, and also don't forget to nest both of these clips together. It just makes things easier to work with. So highlight both of these, right click, nest OK. I know we've made like 20 nests, but it's fine. It looks good. It looks organized. And if you're happy with the results, just continue editing. You got what you want at the end, so subscribe maybe, or check out this video here on the left, maybe become a member like these ones on the right. You know, you can click off the video now. I'm done with everything.